Hi, this is Heidi Samuelson with the Swamp Frogs Blogspot, and I wanted to share with you a way that I've been helping my students prep for online testing using Google Docs. So I've opened up my Google Drive, and if you have a Gmail account, all you have to do is Google Docs, and then it'll come up into your Google Drive. And on Google Drive, there's an object called Create. So in order to create the online test, I'm going to make a form. And usually I do this with the stories that we're reading for the week. And so the first thing I do is I title it with whatever the title of the story is. And this week we just happen to be reading Rosa and Blanca. And then sometimes I go with a default theme, or you have all these different, that when the students go on to take the test, this is what they'll look like when they actually go on there. So let's choose the book classic for this one. And then I can just click OK. And that's going to take me back to getting ready to create this test so that I have control over what the questions say and how the students answer them. So you can see here where it says Rosa and Blanca. And in the form description, I usually write something like, use your text to find evidence for the following questions, because we've been using so much of our text evidence as we delve into our stories deeper, and showing what page we find the evidence on and what the character is saying to help us find out the answer to our questions. So here you can see this is the first question that I want to have, and in order to know who's making this test or who's answering the questions to this test, the first question that I always do is have them type their, I do the last name because you'd be amazed at how many of my second graders need help learning how to type their last name. And so there's many options of the question type that you can have. And so what I usually do here is I'll have a text box. And so this text box right here will show up where they can type in their answer. And I make it a required question, which means that the test will not submit to me unless they've answered this question. And so once you click done, you can see that this is their first question. And just to show you a little bit about what it looks like, when you go up to this area right here, you can check out and see what a live version of this document is going to look like. And so now you can see what the students are actually going to look at as they are creating and finishing their test. And so here's that box that they're going to type their name into before they submit. But we're going to add more questions. So I'm going to go ahead and close this down, and I'm back here on my Google Docs section. And so now I want to add another question item. And so I'm going to go to add an item, and I'm going to click on add the item, and here's the question title. And this is where I always start with my one. And let's say I want to use, when did Rosa plant a garden? And so if there were some type of a text, like I might want to put on here page 360, the students could use their textbook and they could go into page 360 and find the actual words or verbiage that tells them. I don't always do that, but sometimes you can do that, especially with nonfiction stories. So in this particular instance, I want the students to choose one of my choices. So I'm going to choose multiple choice. And option one, I'm going to label as A, and I'm going to give them when she was a little girl as an option. And then for B, I'll give them after she got married. And then for C, I'll give them after Blanca grew corn. And so here are my three choices. And again, if I make this a required question, then when you go back up here to this live form, you can see that the required questions have this little asterisk after them. And something didn't work with that, so let me go back and check and see what I did. Nope, looks like I have it here. Let's go in and edit this and just kind of see what it says that I didn't do. Nope. Looks like everything's there. So let's go back. Oh, there it is. Okay. So some, don't panic when things don't work. Always go back and just check. Sometimes when you turn it off and turn it back on again, it comes back. So now you can see these are the two little red stars that tell me if they don't answer those two questions and they try to submit their answer, it's going to tell them you cannot answer or you can't submit this test until you've answered these. And so I can continue adding items. I can continue adding items as many as you choose. For instance, if I wanted to do something that had to do with one of the high frequency words, and I could put find the word that fits the sentence below, and I in this help text then, I could write a sentence, and then in the instead of a text, I could have them choose from a list some different words that might fit into that sentence. Oops, sorry. And again, if I make this a required question and I click on done, then you can see here they've got to click this box and it'll open up a list. So when we go back to that live form, here's that find the word that fits in the sentence below, Jay walked to the park, and when they click here, they've got some choices that they can choose before they submit. So there's many different types of questions that you can add. And again, you just keep adding the items and writing your question. You can duplicate questions here. So for instance, if I didn't want to have to write that each time, I could duplicate that question and then just change the different sentence and instead say, Julie is my sister. And then here I can change some of my choices. And then I'm not having to type all of this word up in here again, but it's already checked as a required question, and so I have all of this going on. Down here where it says confirmation page, I always unclick the first one that says show a link to submit another response, because I don't want the students having the option of submitting another response and thinking that they have to go through and redo the whole format again. And that's what the younger students, they get a little confused. And so now I've got this live form that I can use this URL, and I can send that URL out to my students and they can go ahead and take that test, or I can up here where it says accepting responses and not accepting responses, I can turn that off and on so that when the students are accept, you know, it tells them when they can and when they can't accept, so nobody can get on to the test before I want them to get on. And then over here, it'll show you how you can send the form to somebody. It'll give you different things on how to get that form together. And so if you'll come back to the next video, I'll show you how I take this format and I put it onto my website, and then my students can click on a portkey on my website to get to a test. So I'm going to stop here because we've just started learning how to create that test, and I'll come back on another video and show you how I use that test with my students in the classroom via my website.